सर मंडे से यूनिट टेस्ट है तो हमारे क्लासेस भी होंगे क्या रेगुलर? सर हेलो
ये समोन ऑफ स्टॉक के
सर,
लिए लाओ,
मंडे से यूनिट टेस्ट है तो हमारे क्लासेस भी होंगे?
जस्ट 1 मिनट ये ना।
We have unit test from Monday, so we will have regular classes also.
बोला हेलो, कैन एनीवन आंसर मी? आवाज आ रही है क्या? क्लियर
Yes, sir.
दिख रहा है? हाँ, जस्ट वेट फॉर 2 मिनट्स, वी विल स्टार्ट डिफरेंट न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑन द सिलेंडर। डिफरेंट सिलेंडर स्केप इन अ वर्टिकल चैनल और सम इंक्लाइन चैनल्स आल्सो। द पीपीटी आल्सो आई हैव शेयर्ड। द सेकंड टाइप ऑफ द क्वेश्चन इन द इक्विलिब्रियम्स आर sometimes they are given the two different weights are connected by a cable, wire or rope. So there one point you must remember while drawing the free body diagram, our third point is when there is a connection of the bodies by means of a cable, wire or rope in the free body diagram, those wire is to be replaced by tension which is acting away from the body. So that third point is important in such cases here. So if you see the diagram, the diagram number one carefully here. This is the diagram number one. This is the question given over here. So here you can see the different pieces of wire are there. The first piece is E to F, F to C, and C to D. These three pieces of the wires are there, and these two weights, weight A and weight B, are connected by means of the three pieces of wire. And he is asking if weight A is 60 newton, how much is the weight B for equilibrium? Equilibrium means this configuration is given. At this stage, we have to put some weight over here, weight B, WB, such that this geometry of the wires will maintain here. Geometry of the wire means, for the equilibrium state, this angle will be 40, this angle will be 20, this angle will be 65 degrees. So here, weight B you have to determine. The question is like this, the weight A and weight B are kept in equilibrium as shown in figure. Determine the weight B if the weight A is equal to 60 Newton. So weight A is given as 60 Newton here. Okay. So here in this case, if you observe it carefully, it seems that it is a non-concurrent force system. Agar main dono weight ek saath mein agar free body diagram nikalta hu, it seems that it is a non-concurrent force system. But if you consider the joint, now you can say that weight A is connected at which joint? Joint F. Weight B is connected at which joint? Joint C. If you consider the free body diagram of the joint separately, so first this is I have drawn it over here. This is a free body diagram of joint F. And this is the free body diagram of joint C. Don't look at this figure. This is the next question. So here, if I consider the free body diagram of the joint F, it looks like this. And clearly, you can say, sir, it is a concurrent force system, right? Similarly, if I draw the free body diagram of the joint C, it again looks as a concurrent force system because all the three forces are passing through the same point. I think there is no doubt in this one. So sabse pehle kya karna hai? Weight 60 Newton is given to you. I am considering weight A is attached at the point F. I am considering the free body diagram of the joint F. If I draw the free body diagram of the joint F, the free body diagram will be like this. The first one, again follow the rules. What are our rules? सबसे पहले हम क्या दिखाते हैं? The weight of the body. What is the weight of the body? The weight A is given at 60 newton. So through the joint F, first show the weight of 60 newton acting vertically downward direction. Then next, our third point in the free body diagram, if there is a connection between the bodies by means of a cable, wire, or rope. It is to be replaced by tension, and tension is acting away from the body. But it's quite natural due to weight A. A will try to pull the wires in the downward direction. So definitely this FC, the wire FC, the portion of the wire FC will be subjected to tension. Similarly, EF will be also subjected to tension, and which is replaced by tension which is acting away from the body. So the wire FC is replaced by PCF. Iska matlab kya hai? P stands for tension and CF is the wire portion here. So tension in wire CF. So this wire FC I am replacing by the tension in the wire CF. Similarly, the wire EF I am replacing by tension in wire EF. And tension is always shown acting away from the body. And if it is compression, then it is shown towards the body. So forget about the compression right now. So here, as I know, if I am applying the weight A due to the wire A, due to the weight A, there will be tensile force created in the induced in the wire EF and FC that I am showing it here. So here, if I considering the joint F, its free body diagram shows it's a concurrent force system. All the three forces are passing through the same point. So I can apply the Lamy's theorem here. So better to go for the Lamy's theorem if only three concurrent forces are there. Otherwise, you have to resolve the forces. You can apply the condition of equilibrium also. That was in the last lecture. Summation of Fx is equal to 0, summation of Fy is equal to 0. But better if you apply the Lamy's theorem if only forces are there. So here, joint F, PCF, 60 Newton and TEF are there. Only important thing is in the Lamy's theorem, you need to determine the angles. By addition or subtraction, easily you can find out the angle. So one by one, we will see what are the angles. So first one, FC. The cable FC is making how much inclination to the horizontal? 20 degrees. So I have shown here 20 degrees here. Then cable EF is making an angle of 40 degrees with the horizontal. So I am showing this 40 degrees out here. While applying the Lamy's theorem, I need the angle between the different forces. So first thing, one by one, we will see. So angle between these two forces, 60 Newton and PCF, this is 20, this is 90 degrees. So 90 plus 20 is 110 degrees here. So why I have shown the angle between the different forces by black here. So angle between these two forces is 110, which is nothing but 90 plus 20. Move to the left hand side. This angle is 40 degrees plus this angle will be 90 degrees, 90 plus 40, which is nothing but 130 degrees. So angle between TEF and 60 Newton is 130 degrees. And for the angle between TCF and TEF, what I have to do? The total angle is 180. So 180 minus 20 minus 40, I am getting 120 degrees. So there is nothing in calculation of the angles. Now straightway, this is the free body diagram of joint F. Okay, analysis will talk about it. Similarly, we will see the free body diagram of the joint C. Joint C ka agar main free body diagram nikal now, this is the joint C. Then wire CD, then weight W, and wire FC. So, sabse pehle hum dikhayenge weight B, WB. WB is the weight B acting in vertically downward direction. Ye mujhe pata nahi hai, this I have to determine. Then the wire CD is replaced by tension in CD. So, this is replaced by TCD, tension in wire CD, which inclination is given to you as 65 degrees. This is given in the question. Similarly, FC is replaced by tension in wire CF. FC or CF are the same thing. And this is making an angle of 20 degrees with the horizontal. This is making an angle of 20 degrees with the horizontal. Now I have shown the angle between the different forces by black color here. So one by one we will see. So first one, in between these two forces, what is the angle? So this much is 90 degrees. So 90 plus 65, which is nothing but 155 degrees. Then come over here. So angle between WB and TCF, this total angle is 90 degrees. 90 minus 20, which is nothing but 70 degrees over here. Then angle between TCD and TCF, I have to find out here. So out of that, this 65 is known to you. If you calculate this angle will be 180. So upper angle is 180. So 180 minus 65. So this much angle I will get. So you can see the pain over here. This angle, if I start to measure it from here to here, it is 180 degrees. 180 minus 65, and then plus 20, I have to add here. So better here, I will write here, 180 minus 65 plus 20. And this is nothing but 165 degrees. Once again, observe this, how I am getting this angle as 165. From here, if I start measuring up to this point, it will be 180 degrees. 180 plus 20, so it is 140 minus 65. 180 plus 20, so that is 200. 200 minus 65, which is nothing but 165 degrees. So this is the free body diagram. So first, very first thing, you get the free body diagram. Then which free body diagram to be considered, that we will see. See, in the Lambis theorem, if one load is known to you or one force is known to you and all the three angles are known to you, then you can apply the Lambis theorem, right? Similarly, now I will find out here. How many unknowns are there? You observe here carefully. The unknowns are TCF and TEF. All the angles are known to you and weight is also known to you. So here only two unknowns are there. If you observe this figure here, here you will find out three unknowns are there. TCF, WB and TCD. So total three unknowns are there by Lambis theorem and all the angles are known to you. So by applying Lambis theorem, I can find out two unknowns here. So better to go for this one. You will not get answer by considering the free body diagram of the joint. So free body diagram of the joint F here. So out of three, if any one is known to you, go for that free body diagram. Okay, so what is Lambis theorem statement says? Again, the Lambis theorem statement is what? If the body is in equilibrium under the action of three concurrent forces, then each force is directly proportional to the sine of the angle between other two forces. Okay, so one by one I will go. First, I will start with 60. 60, which is the opposite angle? 120. So by Lambis theorem, I can write 60 upon sine of, the opposite angle is 120, must be equal to TCF, which is the opposite angle to the TCF. This total angle, angle between the other two forces is 130. So which is nothing but TCF by sine of 130 and must be equal to TEF, and the opposite angle is 110. Opposite to the TEF force, angle I am getting between the other two forces is 110. So I will write here TEF upon sine of the opposite angle is 110 here. So if you apply these two, if you get these two equations, you can identify the TCF value. If you consider these two equations, you can easily determine TEF value here. And from this, you can calculate TCF and TEF value. So last lecture, I told you to sit for the lecture with the calculator. So you calculate and tell me.
Sir,
you can tell me. Yes.
Sir,
TCF is 53.073.
Speak loudly.
Sir, तिथे 135 चा ऐवजी 135 येईल ना?
कुठलं कुठलं?
TCF आणि TCD च्या मध्ये.
TCF
राईट हँड साईडला.
हा फिगर.
165 च्या ऐवजी 135 येईल ना?
135, yes. 180 plus 20, 200, 200 minus 65, 135, correct. So this will be 130, that we will see. So till then you calculate this one. TCF and TEF tell
me the values. Sir, TCD 35 L.
Hello.
See, calculation is the important part in your exam test one also. The question number two will be descriptive. And there you have to calculate. So calculation practice is required. So calculate and tell me. Any one of you calculate and tell me what is the TCF value.
Hello.
TCF value, I'm getting 53.1 meter and a TEF value 65.10. So these are the answers. Now after getting this tension here, now you can go for the free body diagram of the joint C. So before applying the Lambis theorem here, how many unknowns were there? 1, 2, 3. All the three forces were not known to you. Now, out of that, one force is known to you. Which force is known to you? TCF is known to you. So this TCF value we got already, which is nothing but 53.1 newton. Now I can say only two unknowns are there, WB and TCD. So I can apply the Lambis theorem now. Now for this one, apply the Lambis theorem. So the Lambis theorem statement what says? First thing is TCF upon, what is the opposite angle here? Opposite to TCF, the forces are TCD and WB. The angle between them is 155. So sine of 155 must be equal to WB divided by the opposite angle is 135. So WB upon sine of 135 and must be equal to TCD by sine of 7 0. So out of this, TCF is known to you now. TCF already you have calculated, which is to be 53.1. Substitute value here 53.1. Get these two equations, you can find out the value of weight B. And weight B, I'm getting as 88.8. WB is equal to 88.8 and Newton. So from this we can conclude weight B, if the weight B is 88.8 Newton, then only this configuration will be maintained. You understood, all of you understood this one? Agar weight B 88.8 hai, tohi this geometry will maintain. If the weight B is less than 88.8, what will happen? This weight will be lifted up and this angle will change. This angle will change and this angle will change. If weight B is more than 88.8, weight B will pull the whole wire assembly in the downward direction. This angle will change, this angle will change and this angle will change. So to maintain these angles, weight B has to be 88.8 Newtons here. So this is the equilibrium. So we can say if B is equal to, weight B is equal to 88.8, then only this geometry of the wires will be maintained here. Otherwise, these angles will not be maintained. So if anyone has any doubt, you can ask me. In this question, if you, anyone has any doubt, you can ask. Yes, one answer is confirm. D49 Disha, good. 88.79, so we can say 88.8. So no one else is calculating the answer? Only one student is have calculated the answer here.
So I have calculated.
Yes. So this is about the second type of the question where two different weights are given, which are connected by wires here. And even though it looks to be a non-concurrent force system, agar aap dekhoge complete figure to aapko lagega ye non-concurrent force system hai. Weight bhi yahan pe add ho raha hai, weight bhi yahan pe add ho raha hai. Weight A is acting at point F, weight C is acting at point C. So it's a non-concurrent force system. But if you consider the joints separately, F and C, it becomes a concurrent force system and three-fourths concurrent force system, and easily you can apply the Lamy's theorem. So these are the second type of the question. So if you remember in the previous lecture, yesterday's lecture, we have discussed about the different type of the loading, type of loads and type of support. So that we will revise. Okay, so when I will explain it, then it will be easily understood here. What are the different type of the loadings, how to convert the different type of the loadings into a point load, and different type of the support. Because from the next type of the question, the next type of the question is beam reaction question. So beam reaction question, definitely one question will be asked in the exam for 8 marks here. So definitely one beam reaction question is there. So beam, what is mean by the beam? So there are a lot of applications of the beam. When you are traveling, you might have seen the bridges are there. Bridges kya hote, different columns are there, and above that the beam is placed. Even if you are sitting in a room, upar dekhoge to aapko ek beam dikhai dega. The whole structure of the building are consisting of columns. The vertical jo hote, columns hote, uske upar jo aata hai, beams aata hai. So beam, if I have to define, I will say beam is a structural member having one dimension larger compared to the other two dimensions. Yani length jo hota hai upar ke beam ka, it is very large as compared to the cross section of the beam. And it carries the load. The main purpose of the beam is to carry the load, and they are supported. Aap dekhoge dono columns hote hai, the vertical columns are there, uske upar beam aata hai. So these beams are supported on the columns, and whatever the loading, suppose if you are sitting on the first floor or the ground floor, upar ka jo load hai, upar jo log rehte hai, upar ka unka saman jo hai, that load is coming on directly on the beam. And as beams are supported on the columns are providing the reactions. Okay, and how the beams are supported, the different supports we have discussed in the last lecture. So one by one, we will see the different type of the loading and the different type of the supports. So the reactions provided by the column are depending upon the what type of support it is there. So these different type of the supports and different type of the loading we are going to discuss here. So first one is the type of loading. First load we are going to consider here. So first type of the loading, now the topic is type of loading. So one by one we will see. The first one, let us say, this is the beam given to you. And it is acted upon by the different load, two loads I am showing. Let us say this is 60 Newton and this is 50 Newton. This is the point A and this is the point B. Such type of the loading is called direct loading or point load. Why it is called point load? If anyone asks you where the 50 Newton force is acting, where the 50 Newton load is acting, you will say it is acting at point A. Similarly, if anyone asks you where the 60 Newton force is acting, you will say it is acting at point B. So the loads or forces acting at a particular points are called as point load. Is it clear to everyone? Point load or direct load? Is it clear to everyone now? Point load means the forces or loads acting at a particular point are called as point load or direct load. So what are the other type of the loadings there? The second type of the loading, it is called as UDL. The meaning of UDL is uniformly distributed load. So how is the uniformly distributed load? It is represented like this. This is the beam given here. So two type of the representation of loadings are there. And here it is written as W Newton per meter. And this is the length of the UDL. This is the one type of the representation of UDL, uniformly distributed load. Or sometimes this is also called as rectangular load. This is the another representation of UDL. The lower one is a beam portion and it is loaded by uniformly distributed load and its intensity is W Newton per meter and its length is nothing but L. So these are the two ways of representation of uniformly distributed load. In short, it is called as UDL. Now, while calculating, while analyzing the different forces, I need to convert UDL into a point load. So how to convert this into a point load, that we will see. So what is the meaning of intensity? The loading is spread over the beam here. For every meter, how much is the weight? W Newton. W Newton per meter. 1 meter agar consider kar diya, the total load will be W. Second meter, again W. Third meter, again W. So here, in the free body diagram, I will show the free body diagram here. Let us say this is the beam or body is AB. And then, I will convert this into a point load P. P is nothing but W into L. W is what? Intensity, means the load per meter. For every length, for every 1 meter, how much is the length? W. And how much is the length of the beam here? L. So straight away I will say the equivalent point load P for UDL is nothing but W into L here. So P is equal to W into L. This is the way to convert the UDL into a point load here. Then problem comes where it will be. This is A and this is B. So this will be L by 2 and this will be L by 2. The UDL can be converted into a point load by equivalent point load of UDL P is equal to W into L. W is the intensity of the loading and L is the length of the UDL. How much length it is spread? The UDL is spread over the length L. So the total equivalent load is P is equal to W into L. This is the way to convert UDL into the point load or direct load. And where it acts? It will act at the center of the span. Total length in my L. And it will act at a distance of L by 2 from A or L by 2 from B. So two different type of the loading, point load and this is UDL. Then the another load is called, the third one is UVL. So U stands for uniformly, V stands for varying and L stands for load. Uniformly varying load. And it is sometimes it is also called as triangular load. It is represented this way. Suppose this is the beam AB portion is given to you. On one side, intensity is 0 Newton per meter. whereas on the other side, the intensity is W Newton per meter. So you can see clearly, the intensity varies linear. This is the difference here. In the UDL, what happens? The intensity is constant. Throughout the beam, the intensity of the loading is constant, W Newton per meter. But in case of the UVL, on one side, the intensity is 0 Newton, and it is increasing linearly. And on the other side, the other end B, the intensity is W Newton per meter. So the basic figure you can see, this is also called as rectangular load, because the figure formed is a rectangle, right? Now here, this is also sometimes called as triangular loading, because the load figure is triangle. When a triangle is there, on one side it is 0, on the other side it is W, the intensity. And suppose this is equal to L, the length of the beam is L. Then its free body diagram, this is A, B. Its equivalent point load, because I need to convert this triangular load into equivalent point load. Equivalent point load for UVL is nothing but, now you can see, here we are saying the equivalent point load is what? W into L. Can I say this is the area of the rectangle? Intensity height is W and length is L. So area of the rectangle I am saying. So in case of the UDL, uniformly distributed load, the equivalent point load is nothing but the area of the rectangle formed. Now here, what figure is formed here? It's a triangle. So what is the area of the triangle? Half of base into height. So I can say equivalent point load for UDL is nothing but half of W into L. So it is so simple. Because the uniformly varying load, a triangle is formed, and area of the triangle is nothing but half of base into height. So half of W into L. Equivalent point load will be is equal to half of W into L. Now the next point is where it acts. In case of UDL, where it was acting? It was acting at the center of the span. So here also, it will act at the center of the span, but here, the center of the triangle. Now centroid of the triangular area, you are going to study in the next topic, centroids of Ayagata of Dekinium. Right now only where it will act that I will show here. This is going to act at a distance of L by 3 from point of highest intensity or 2L by 3 from the point of zero intensity. So the first one is equivalent point load for UVL or triangular load is nothing but half of W into L, where W is the highest intensity, L is the length of the beam. And it is acting at the distance of L by 3. L by 3 distance from where? Point of highest intensity. Highest intensity at the point B. So from the point B at a distance of L by 3. Or you can say 2L by 3 distance from the lowest intensity. Zero intensity is equivalent to 2L by 3. So I will say it is acting at a distance of 2L by 3 from A, or it is L by 3 distance from point B. So these are the different type of the loadings. The first one is point load, second one is uniformly distributed load, third one is uniformly varying. Now the next type of the loading is called trapezoidal loading, which is nothing but the combination of these two. Okay, that I will show here. Next one is called trapezoidal loading. So what is the trapezoidal loading? That is simple. And easily we can convert that trapezoidal loading into, it's a combination of UDL and UVL. It is like this. This is the beam AB. So only difference is here. In the UVL, at the one end, the intensity is 0 Newton. Instead of that, it is having some here. So at the highest intensity, this is the beam AB. The length is L. This is W 2 Newton per meter. And on other side, on left hand side, this is W1 Newton per meter. So you can see it here, that a trapezoid is formed. A trapezium is formed. That's why this type of the loading is called trapezoidal loading. So on one side, see the difference here. In the UVL, uniformly varying load or triangular load, on one of the end, the intensity is zero. Instead of that, on one of the end, the intensity is not zero, it is W1 Newton per meter. So at point A, the intensity of the loading is W1. It varies linearly, and at the other end, the intensity is W2 Newton per meter. So here what I will do, I can convert this into two different type of the loading. How I can convert that, I will show here. So here what I am considering, just observe the blue color part. This is area 1, and area 2. I'm dividing this trapezoidal loading into two different parts. The lower part is the area 1. The upper part is area 2. Can anyone tell me what is the type of loading of area number 1? Area
1. Uniformly distributed load.
Area number 1 is what type of loading?
UVL. UDL.
Yes. And area 2?
UVL. UVL.
Triangular loading. Yes. So we can see here, this blue color rectangle is nothing but UDL. Or uska intensity kitna hai? W1. Length kitna hai? L. And the upper portion, area number 2, is the triangular loading. So I will convert this trapezoidal loading into two equivalent point loads. So how to convert this? So get the extension of A, get the extension of B. This is the beam AB. The first one is, I will consider the area 1. Equivalent point load as P1. And for the UDL, you know, in case of UDL, what is the total point load? Area of the rectangle or intensity into length. Intensity is how much? W1. So W1 into L. This is the equivalent point load for area number 1, which is the UDL. Similarly, go for area number 2. And I know this distance will be this equivalent point load for the UDL acts at a distance of L by 2, center of the length. So this is L by 2. Now similarly, go for the area P2. The equivalent point load for area 2, for the triangular load. Again, I know the area of the triangle. Area of the triangle will be how? What is the area of the triangle? Half of base into height. So base is L. So how much will be this height? Can anyone tell me? The total is W2. The total height is W2. Out of that, W1 already was considered. W1 to here again. So I will say this is nothing but W2 minus W1. Now half of W2 minus W1 into L. So two different types I can convert. The trapezoidal loading is converted into UDL plus UVL. So two equivalent point load you will get. Equivalent point load for the UDL is W1 into L. Equivalent point load for the UVL is nothing but half of W2 minus W1 into L here. And as we know, the equivalent point load for the triangle acts at a distance of L by 3 distance from the highest intensity. So this distance will be is equal to L by 3. So you must remember here, L by 3 is distance from the point of highest intensity. Agar A pe highest intensity aa raha hai, so at that time L by 3 distance will come here. So while solving the question, you can see the figure now, the question number 2. In the question number 2, the UDL is also given to you, UVL is also given to you. This question will be asked for 8 marks. That we will see at the end of the lecture. So for now, you can convert this UDL into a point load, this UVL into point load here, right? So if this is understood, if anyone has any doubt, you can ask me. In the type of loading, anyone has any doubt?
No.
No one has any doubt? In the type of loading, observe it once again and tell me if anyone has any doubt.
So from W1, hello?
Yes.
So from W1, the length will be L by 3 or 2L by 3?
This one you are talking?
Yes, sir, but that from W1.
Which one? Speak loudly.
From
W1.
Yeah, length from that.
This is W1. This is W2. Your doubt here? W2 minus W1?
No, sir. From there, we have taken L by 3. So, from that opposite side, from A, we will take how much distance?
You're talking about this one?
No, sir. From that, from both the sides, we will take L by 3. Or from A side, we will take 2L by 3.
No. Two different. So this is the UVL. This is UVL at a distance of 2L, it is L by 3. And if you want to show, this will be 2L by 3. This is 2L by 3.
Yes, sir, that only I was asking.
Okay, I think it is clear now.
Yes, sir.
About the confusion, I am not showing 2L by 3. From point B, it will be L by 3. ठीक है ओके. सो दिस इज अबाउट द डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ द लोडिंग which is to be required while solving the question. On the right hand top you can see that question at the end we are going to solve here. Now we will see the different type of the support. Yesterday also we have discussed about the different type of the supports. Now one by one, what are these supports we are going to study here? So as we have discussed right now, the beams are supported on both sides or many times at many points. In between also the beams are supported. And these support provide the reaction because of the loading coming on the beam. Let us say you are moving over a bridge. So number of vehicles are moving on the bridge. That bridge is nothing but the beam. And whatever the loading coming on the bridge, they are supported by the columns. And these columns are providing reactions. And there are different type of the supports. And depending upon the type of support, the reactions will come in picture. So first type of the supports here, so we will consider the first support. The first support is called, it is represented like this. So beam I am showing partially. Let us say at the end A, it is supported. So simply it is kept. If there it will be clear, picture is shown over there. So in this type of the support, simply the beam is kept. This is called the simple support. In case of this one, this is simple support. Or knife edge support. This type of the support is called simple or knife edge support. Simply the beam is kept on the support, right? So here, how many reactions now? How many reactions will be there in this type of the support? That is important here. So if you remember in the first lecture of the equilibrium, I told you reaction is nothing but restriction to the movement. Restriction to the movement of the body is nothing but the reaction. Okay. Now I'm standing over here. My weight is acting in downward direction, but my downward motion is restricted by what? By the reaction from the ground. So restriction to the movement is nothing but the reaction. Now here, if I load it here, if this beam is over here, let us say this is the beam AB. If a vertical load is acting in the downward direction, can the beam move in the downward direction? No. Means there's vertical restriction is there. So here if I have to show a free body diagram, only one reaction will be there. And that reaction is nothing but RE, and which is vertical. VA is restricted from moving in vertical downward direction. But if I apply the force here, if I apply the force for beam horizontally, there is no restriction. The beam is easily free to move horizontally. That's why only one reaction is there, RA or VA. Similarly, there is another type of the support which is called the roller support. This is called roller support. And it is represented like this. In case of the roller now, this type of the support is called roller support. Or from the diagram you can say easily, simply it is kept on a support which is having roller here. Means the beam is free to move horizontally. The rollers will move, right? And if you load it vertically downward direction, if any load is coming on the beam in the perpendicular direction, there will be restriction for the movement. So in this type also, the reaction will be only one. Reaction will be vertical reaction, and that is RE. So in case of simple support or knife edge support or roller support, there will be having only one reaction, and that is vertical reaction. Because the vertical movement is restricted by the support. Now, let us see about the next now. The next one is knife edge support. Okay. Next is called beam support. And beam supports are represented like this. The difference between knife edge and beam support is here. Kali yahan pe thoda dark ho jata hai. This is the point A. In the knife edge support or the simple support, yahan pe simply a triangle was shown, but here it is highlighted. So this is the representation of hinge support. Hinge support means, I think all of you know, your doors are fixed to the frame by means of the hinges, different hinges hote hain. Darwaje ka agar dekhoge to aap teen hinges hote hain. So that is nothing but the hinge support. And hinge support mein door kya hota hai? Door can only rotate. If you apply the force to the door, door is rotating about the hinges. It is not moving vertically or horizontally, right? Means its vertical and horizontal motion is restricted over here. As it is hinged at point E, if I apply the force here, this will be restricted, right? Means there is a horizontal reaction. There is a horizontal restriction for the movement. At the same time, if I load the beam here, definitely this hinge support will provide one more reaction here. So from this, you can say total two reactions are there. In case of the hinge support, the door is not moving horizontally, door is not moving vertically, but it is free to rotate here. And so how many reactions will be there in the hinge support? So here, in case of the hinge support, two reactions will be there, which are preventing the vertical motion of the beam and horizontal motion of the beam. So better to give the notation like this. V stands for vertical reaction at A. X stands for horizontal reaction at E. Okay, so two components of the reactions you are getting, VA and HA. And if I have to find out a single reaction, that reaction will be RA, which is making an angle of theta. This is the resultant. Resultant of this two is reaction RA. But basically, in case of hinge support, there are two components of the reaction. Vertical component of the reaction is VA, horizontal component of the reaction is HA, and resultant reaction is RA. And which can be found out by the formula RA. Just our resultant ka formula. Resultant kya hota hai? R is equal to square root of summation of Fx square plus summation of Fy square. Similarly here, RA is nothing but square root of HA square plus VA square. Right? And theta. This theta is nothing but tan inverse VA by HA. So the conclusion is, in case of the hinge support, the two reaction components are there because the vertical motion is restricted by the vertical reaction VA, horizontal motion is restricted by horizontal component HA. And if I resolve this HA and VA into a single force, that will be RA. So resultant reaction of HA and VA is RA is equal to HA square plus VA square, and its inclination is given by theta is upon A. Now the next type of the support is called fixed support or fixed support. Now this is also called as built-in support, BUILTIN. So fixed support mein kya hota hai? Now before going to the fixed support, just observe the knife, observe the hinge support here. In case of the hinge support, there is no horizontal movement of the body, there is no vertical movement of the beam here, but this is free to rotate. If I apply the force from this direction, our door is rotating. Our door is free to rotate. So the movement is not protected. The rotation is not protected. And which is also protected in fixed support. So in fixed support, what is there? This is the representation of the fixed support. This is the beam. And it is fixed in a wall. Completely fixed. This is A and this is point D. This is the representation of fixed support. So this is fixed in a concrete. हमारा बीम जो होता है अपने बिल्डिंग का जो बीम ऊपर आप देखोगे तो बीम दिखाई देगा. इट इज फिक्स्ड इन द सीमेंट कंक्रीट. सो इफ आई अप्लाई इन हॉरिजॉन्टल लोड, देयर इज नो मूवमेंट, मींस द हॉरिजॉन्टल कंपोनेंट ऑफ द रिएक्शन इज देयर. इफ आई अप्लाई वर्टिकल मूवमेंट, इट डजंट मूव वर्टिकली, सो रिएक्शन वर्टिकल इज ऑल्सो देयर, एज वेल एज द बीम कैन नॉट रोटेट, मींस देयर इज अ मूवमेंट ऑल्सो. सो इन द फ्री बॉडी डायग्राम, इफ फिक्स सपोर्ट इज गिवन, so here two components of the reactions will be there, VA, horizontal component is HA, and in addition to that, a moment M is acting, a couple M is acting, which prevents the rotation of the beam. Just imagine, agar rotation nahi hoga to beam rotate ho jayega, building collapse ho jayega. So this, due to the fixed support, there are two components of the reaction, HA and VA, and in addition to that, it prevents the rotation of the beam by a couple M over here. So these are the different type of the support. So first, roller support or knife edge support, only one reaction is there. Hinge support, two reactions component are there, VA and HA, which can be clubbed together by RA is equal to HA square plus VA square square root, and theta is equal to tan inverse VA by HA. In case of the fixed support, there is no horizontal movement, there is no vertical movement, means two reactions is there, HA and VA, and in addition to that, one couple is also acting. So it means that suppose if any weight WP is kept over here, this node P will try to rotate the beam in clockwise direction. It is provided by, it is restricted by a couple acting at A by M. So M value will be as per the P. So in case of the fixed support, there is no vertical movement, there is no horizontal movement. So two reactions are there. In addition to that, one couple is acting of magnitude M, and its direction depends upon the different the type of the movement you are getting due to the force P. Iska movement clockwise hai, to ye anti-clockwise hoga. If I am applying the force like this from the downward direction, the moment will be anti-clockwise. Ye couple ka direction clockwise ho jayega. So this is about the different type of the loading and different type of the supports here. If anyone has any doubt, we can go further. Now we are going to study the one numerical on this one. चलते आगे. होप एनीवन हैज नो डाउट. यस, observe the figure on the right hand side of the board. The question is common. A beam AB is loaded as shown in figure. Determine the support reactions. Sare beam reaction questions mein the question to wahi rahega. A beam AB, only name will change. Instead of AB, someone may say EF, someone may say XY. So the beam AB, so this is the beam AB, this rectangular portion is beam AB. It's loaded as shown in figure. Determine the reaction at the support. A is a hinge support and B is a roller support. Clear? Question is clear. So always what you have to do in such type of questions, these are very easy type of the question compared to the previous cylinder question. There you have to apply some mind. Here straightway in three different equations you are getting directly the answer. So remember, this is very easy question. Okay, so first kya karna hai, draw the figure as it is on the paper. आप कैंसर शीट पे जो फिगर दिया है प्रोपोर्शनेट फिगर ड्रॉ करो. ओके, आई हैव ड्रॉन द फिगर. देन ड्रॉ द फ्री बॉडी डायग्राम. सो फ्री बॉडी डायग्राम क्या होगा, फ्रॉम ए गेट द एक्सटेंशन, फ्रॉम द 30 न्यूटन फोर्स गेट द अनदर एक्सटेंशन, द एंड बी गेट द थर्ड एक्सटेंशन बाय द डायरेक्शनल लाइंस. सो जहां जहां पे लोडिंग है, सो ओवर हियर दिस इज द एंड ऑफ द बीम ए, गेट अ वर्टिकल लाइन और डैशड लाइन. Loading 30 kN is here, so from there get the another line, and from the third support, the third point, the support B, get one more line. Then show the beam. So ye beam ho gaya, the blue color one I am representing, the beam AB is there. So this is the free body diagram of the beam. Ye this is the presentation, this is the representation of the body. So simply this blue color line AB represents your beam. Then show the support reaction. So this is important topic here. Now the first one is A, support A. It is given in the question. Always in question, in your syllabus, one will be a hinge support, another will be a roller support. So do itna yaad rakho. Roller support mein kya hota hai, only one reaction is there perpendicular to the support. Whereas in hinge support, two reactions are there. One is the vertical reaction and another is the horizontal reaction. So this A support is to be replaced by reaction. I know in case of the hinge support, this is the hinge support over here. A is given as hinge support, or from the figure you can say clearly. Here it is a dot over here at the point A. Means it is a hinge support. Hinge supports may two reactions hoti hai. One horizontal restriction and there is one vertical restrictions here. And that I will replace by two components of the reaction. One is HA, horizontal reaction is HA, and vertical reaction is VA. So first, सबसे पहले क्या करना है? Whatever the supports are given, that show the reactions of the support. The support A, I know it is a hinge support. So it will be 1 day. Can you answer? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
आवाज आ रही है क्या?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, I will continue. Yes, so then, after getting the reaction at support A, next is to get the reaction at support B. Roller का मतलब क्या है? This pane is nothing but a roller, and my hand is a beam. So my hand is free to move horizontally. Roller roll हो जाएगा. So my hand is nothing but a beam. Beam is free to move horizontally. Means there is no horizontal reaction. But If I try to push my hand in the downward direction, the roller will restrict its vertical movement. So as I told, reaction is nothing but restriction to the movement. So there is only one restriction here, and which is vertical. Ek hi reaction isliye main direct isko RB bolte tha. RB is the only one reaction is there at the roller. So सबसे पहले क्या करना है? Beam का free body diagram निकालना है. So सबसे पहले in the free body diagram, show the support reaction. So support reactions are HA and VA for the beam support. And for roller support, it is only one reaction, RB is there. Okay. Then now show the different loading. सबसे पहले देखोगे point load. This 30 kilonewton point load is there at a distance of 6 meter. So as it is, show the 30 kilonewton weight here. This is the force of 30 kilonewton. Whatever the point load given in the diagram, show that one. So first सबसे आ जाएगा 30 kilonewton. Then you will see at the same point. One moment is also acting. And what is the moment? 40 kilonewton meter. So don't forget to show that. So this is 40 kilonewton meter. First, whatever the point loads are there, what is the direct loading are there, show the direct loading in the free body diagram. Next. Next, you will see there are two other types of loading. This is UDL and this is UVL. Let us say this is the first type of the loading and this is the second type of the loading. I have to convert this UDL into a point load as well as UVL into a point load. So one by one, we will see what happens here. So let us say for the UDL, equivalent point load is P1. So how to calculate P1? We know equivalent point load for the UDL is nothing but intensity into length. What is the intensity given over here? Intensity of the UDL is given as 20 and L is how much? 6. So P1 is nothing but 20 into 6. So this is 120 newton or kilonewton. Anyone had it out here? Intensity of the loading is given as 20 kilonewton per meter. Length of the UDL blue color loading is given at 6 meter. So the equivalent point load for UDL P1 is nothing but 20 into 6 is equal to 120 kilonewton. And where it acts? It acts at the center. So total distance kitna hai? 6. 6 ka center kahan pe aayega? 652. And it acts, so you have to write all these things at L by 2 equals to 6 by 2 equals to 3 meter from point A or B. So, ye ho gaya. UDL I have converted into a point load. Magnitude will be intensity 20 multiplied by the length of the UDL is 6. So, that is 120 kilonewton. And it is acting at a distance of L by 2. L is 6. L by 2 6 means it is 3 meter above the point A. Now you can show the point load here. And as you know, this is P1 equals to 120, and this distance is nothing but 3 meter, and this is also 3 meter. Observe the free body diagram carefully. This is the equivalent point load for UDL 120 newton, kilonewton, and it is acting at the center, means this distance has to be 3, this distance has to be 3. Now similarly convert UVL. So it is UVL means the triangular loading. This loading now. Loading number 2. This is uniformly varying load. And to convert the uniformly varying load, let us say equivalent point load is equal to P2. And P2 is nothing but area of the so half of what is the highest intensity? On one side the triangular loading intensity is 0. On the point B, it is 45 kilonewton. So W at highest intensity is 45. So this is 45 into L. Length is how much? It is 4 meter. So this is nothing but 4. And I think this is nothing but 90 kilonewtons. So area of the triangle. Area of the triangle is nothing but half of base into height. Height is 45 because the highest intensity is 45. So after calculation, I will get it as 90 kilonewtons. Then the next one is, it acts. Where it acts? As we know, L by 3 distance from L by 3 from highest intensity point is B. The UVL always act at a distance of L by 3 from the highest intensity point B. Or we can say this is nothing but L by 3 is equal to what? L is 4 by 3, which is nothing but I think 1.33 meters per meter. So B se kitne point pe aayega? This will be 1.33 meters. So here I will show, this will be P2 equals to 90, and this distance will be 1.33. Now this is the complete free body diagram. All the reactions I have shown, all the support reactions I have shown, all the loading I have shown, I have converted all the UVL and UVL into its equivalent point load P1 and P2. And in this question, in the beam reaction questions, this FPD carries 2 marks. If your FPD is correct, the 2 marks will be given to you. As I told you previously, the marking will be done by in the step. So this carries 2 marks. If your FPD is correct, then your answer will be correct here. I think now this is over. Now only 3 unknowns are there. HA, VA and RB. And we got the 3 equations. This is a non-concurrent force system. So for the equilibrium of the non-concurrent force system, summation of Fx has to be 0, summation of F of y is equal to 0, and summation of moment is equal to 0. Now here the logic is which equation to apply. Now then what I have to do? You have to write applying conditions of equilibrium. Applying conditions of equilibrium. Let us see what happens. One by one. There you have to write apply COE, conditions of equilibrium. So if I apply the first condition here, suppose let us say I am applying summation of f of x is equal to 0. Always you have to look to the free body diagram. Addition of all horizontal forces is 0. So how many horizontal forces are there? I think only one horizontal force is there, xa. There is no other horizontal forces acting on the beam. So from this I will say xa is equal to 0. So a cancel will be, ha has to be is equal to 0. Then if you apply the another condition, summation of f of y is equal to 0, one by one I am going to see, ek side se start karo, start from one end and go towards the right hand side. So I am starting from A. At A what force is acting? VA, acting in upward direction, so plus. Move towards right, 120, acting in downward direction, minus. 30 downward, minus. 90 downward, minus. And RB is plus. So here you will get the equation, VA plus RB minus 120, minus 30, minus 90 will be is equal to 0. So one equation you will get. You will not get the answer from this equation. You will get an equation in terms of VA and RB. And that equation I am getting as VA plus RB is equal to, you can also find out that VA plus RB, straight you can add here. 120 plus 90, 210, 210 plus 30, it is 240. 240. Let us say this is equation number 1. So by applying summation of Fx equation, I am getting 1 answer, that is HA is equal to 0. By applying condition, second condition, summation of F of Y is equal to 0, I am getting the equation VA plus RB is equal to 0. Ek equation baki hai abhi, which will give me the answer. So which equation is left now? कौन सा इक्वेशन बाकी है? मोमेंट इक्वेशन बाकी है. नाउ हियर आई विल अप्लाई द इक्वेशन समेशन ऑफ मोमेंट अबाउट ए इज इक्वल टू 0. आई एम टेकिंग द मोमेंट अबाउट ए. अगेन गो टू द फ्री बॉडी डायग्राम. इफ आई एम टेकिंग द मोमेंट अबाउट ए, स्टार्ट फ्रॉम ए एंड गो टुवर्ड्स राइट. एट ए वी ए एंड एच ए आर एक्टिंग, सो ये दोनों का मोमेंट 0 हो जाएगा बिकॉज HA and VA are acting at point A. I am taking the moment at point A. So, ye dono ka moment 0 ho jayega. Then, The next will be 120 newton per direction. It is clockwise, so it is minus 120 multiplied by the perpendicular distance, how much? 3. So 120 into 3, and as it is clockwise, I will consider it as negative. So minus 120 into 3. Next, 30 kilonewton force, move the force towards the joint, towards the point A, this is your A point. Again, you are getting the clockwise moment, again it is negative, and minus 30 into perpendicular distance, kitna hai? This perpendicular distance is 3 plus 3, 6. So this is 6. Then don't forget to add or subtract. This is the moment given already here. This is a clockwise moment.
Hello.
Minus 90 into 10 minus 1.33. And finally, RB is acting in the upward direction. Its movement will be anticlockwise. Anticlockwise movement is to be considered as positive. So plus RB into 10 equals to 0. So once again, verify the equation. This is important equation. I will repeat this equation once again. I am taking the moment above A. So HA and VA, they are passing through A. So their moment will be 0. Moment kya hota hai? It's a product of force and perpendicular distance. Point A is here, right? Then consider the point P1. Consider the force P1. This is P1 acting in the downward direction. This is the point A. So its movement will be definitely clockwise direction. So movement of 120 is clockwise, which is to be negative, and its magnitude will be 120 multiplied by 3. So minus 120 multiplied by 3. Move towards right, 30 kilonewton. Its movement is also acting in the downward direction. Its movement about A will be again clockwise, again minus, perpendicular distance is 6. So minus 30 into 6. A couple is given to you, this clockwise couple is given. Clockwise couple magnitude is 40. So it is again, as it is clockwise, minus 40 will be there. Go to the next force, 90 newton, 90 kilonewton. It's acting in the downward direction. If I move the force in the downward direction towards A, I am going to get the clockwise direction here. Clockwise distance to be considered minus 90 into perpendicular distance. This total distance I need. Total I have not thus. 10 minus 1.33 will be this distance here. This distance I want from A to this point, which is nothing but the total length is 10 minus 1.33. 10 minus 1.33. And lastly, RB is acting in the upward direction. Its movement will be anticlockwise. Anticlockwise movement is considered to be positive. So it will be plus RB multiplied by the total distance is 10. RB multiplied by total distance is 10. And from this equation, I can find out RB. And RB, and anyone got RB? 136.03. RB directly mil gaya. Then if you substitute the value over here in this equation, substitute the value of RB in equation 1, I will get the value of VA. And VA I am getting as 103.97. And now I told you, HA and VA are the horizontal and vertical component of the reaction at A. Like, HA is equal to 0. So we can say here, as HA is equal to 0, RA is equal to, any component bacha hai, that is VA, and which is nothing but 103.97. And this is Newton. So reaction at B is 136. Reaction at A, RA is nothing but VA, because HA is equal to 0, and this is nothing but 103.9 Newton. So this carries 8 marks. If your free body diagram is correct, then your whole answer will be correct here. Now, if anyone has any doubt, just go through the different steps I have drawn over there. And if you have any doubt, ask me. And this question of 8 marks will be asked in the exam. And comparability is easy. If you practice for 2-3 more questions, easily you can find out the solution for you. Further support reaction questions. Yes, any doubt? Draw the free body diagram AB, the beam AB, blue color line. Then show the loading first. Loading kaun sa hai usme, direct loading kaun sa hai, point load 30 kN. The same 30 kN force I am showing it here. Then show the support reaction. Two supports are there, support A and support B. Support A is a hinge support. Hinge support mein kya hote hai, do reactions hoti hai, ek vertical reaction hoti hai, ek horizontal reaction hoti hai. So at A, show the two reaction HA and VA. One more thing. Here you are assuming that VA is upward and HA is towards right. This is the assumption. In case if your assumption is wrong, what will happen? You will get the negative answer. यहाँ पे मैं assume कर रहा हूँ HA right में act हो रहा है, VA ऊपर act हो रहा है. अगर आपका assumption wrong है, तो ये answer VA का negative आएगा. इसका मतलब है कि it is acting in downward direction. You can change the sign here. Then heat support हो गया. Roller support is B. B is the roller support. In case of the roller support, you are getting only one reaction. One reaction is RB. I think it is clear. पहले support reactions दिखा दो. दोनों. A is a hinge support. So two reactions, VA and HA. B is a roller support. So only one reaction, that is RB. Then two different loadings are there. I have written here one. The loading one, it's a UDL. Loading two, it's a UVL or triangular loading. So UDL convert करने के लिए intensity कितना दिया है? 20 kN per meter. Means for every meter, how much is the load? 20 kN. So total अपना length कितना UDL का? 6 meter. So let us say equivalent point load for UDL is P1 is equal to 120. ये 120 कहाँ से लाया था मैंने? W into L. W कितना है अपना intensity? 20. Length कितना है? 6. So this is 120 kN. ये clear हो गया? This is the equivalent point load for UDL. Intensity W multiplied by L. W is given 20, L is 6 here. And it acts at the center. UDL ka total length L hai, L by 2 pe wo act karega at the center of the span. So this will be 3 meter and this is 3 meter. Then second one is P2. Equivalent point load for the triangular loading. Equivalent point load for the triangular loading is P2. Ye aa gaya 90. 90 kahan se aa gaya? The formula is half of W into L. Which is nothing but half of W is 90, sorry, W is 45 and L is 4 meter here. This distance is 4. So half of 45 into 4, which is nothing but 90. And it acts at a distance of L by 3 from the highest intensity. Highest intensity kahan pe aa raha hai? B pe. Yahan se L by 3. So total L is how much? 4. 4 by 3. 4 by 3 is nothing but 1.33. So this distance will be 1.33. Clear? Who was asking to explain? Explain करने के लिए किसने बोला था? I think it is clear to everyone now. So thank you. We'll stop here. Yes.
Sir, वो RA resultant force है.
RA?
RA sir resultant force.
हाँ, ये रिजल्टेंट आ गया. आर ए इज द रिजल्टेंट. क्या होता है? एच ए एंड वी ए. दिस इज वी ए एंड दिस इज एच ए, है ना? ये दो फोर्सेस है. दिस इज वी ए एंड दिस इज एच ए. उसका रिजल्टेंट फाइंड आउट करना होता है हमको. बट ये मेरा जीरो आ गया. एच ए जो है, एच ए वैल्यू आई गॉट एज जीरो. तो रिएक्शन ओनली वर्टिकल. सो वी ए इज नथिंग बट आर ए. क्लियर? अगर ये दोनों भी रहते, एच ए हैज गॉट सम वैल्यू, एच ए अगर मुझे कुछ वैल्यू आता था तो मुझे रिएक्शन आर ए फाइंड आउट करना पड़ता था. आर ए इज इक्वल टू स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ एच ए स्क्वायर प्लस वी ए स्क्वायर. क्लियर? शैल वी कंक्लूड? एनी आंसर? थैंक यू. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट यू कैन आस्क मी ऑन द व्हाट्सएप. माय नंबर इज देयर. You can WhatsApp me your doubt here. Thank you. We'll stop here.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.